Okay, so children, yesterday we have completed exercise 4. Okay, including multiplication of integers, division of integers, and then exercise 4 word problems and all those we have completed in the previous class. So today the next topic of integers is the properties of integers. Properties of integers. In 6th class we have learned about properties of whole numbers. Okay. There you have learned about properties of whole numbers. Now, what are those properties that you have learned? Nothing but you know already. We have 4 properties. That is closure property, commutative property, associative property, and then distributive property. Okay. So today I'll explain about those properties. Okay. So first property. What is that first property I said? Addition we are considering, that means we have to consider a plus b. of a plus b. Add these two. Minus 2 plus 3. Minus 2 plus 3. How much it is? 3 plus and 2 minus. So if you want, you can roughly check also. So what is the answer? Plus 1. Plus 1 means plus 1. Plus 1 is also an integer. This is also belongs to integer set. It is also an integer. That means a plus b belongs to integers. Therefore, integers are closed under addition. Integers are closed under addition. Now go for subtraction. And go for subtraction again. Let same this kundam. Minus 2 comma 3 belongs to I. 2 minus 2 and 3. A and B. Now if you consider here subtraction. So under addition means we have considered A plus B. And here subtraction means what you have to consider? A minus B. For subtraction you have to consider A minus B. Minus 2, minus 3. Now minus 2 and minus 3. Both are minus. So you can add minus 2 and minus 3 means minus 5. Which is also belongs to integer set. That means integers are also closed. A minus B is also belongs to I. Therefore, integers are closed under subtraction. Integers are closed under subtraction. Now we have verified under addition and we have verified under subtraction. Then what we have more two we have multiplication and division. So we go for multiplication. So multiplication again. Let 2 comma 4 belongs to I. This is A and this is B. And we now go for A into B. 2 into 4, 8, which is also an integer. When you multiply two integers, you are also getting again an integer. You are getting again an integer. That means integers are A into B is also an integer. Therefore, integers are closed under multiplication. So under multiplication also they are closed. Now what do we have? What is left? Division. Now coming to division. Again, consider any two numbers of integers. Let 3 comma 0 belongs to I. This is A and this is B. 3 is an integer, 0 is also an integer. Okay. Now, in division, what do you have? A divided by B. A divided by B. So, 3 divided by 0. Now, can you divide a number by 0? Is it possible to divide a number by 0? No. See, can you divide it? 0. Then can you divide it? 0 ones are 0. 0 twos are 0. 0 threes are 0. Can you divide it? Not at all possible to divide. So that's why we write it as not defined. So here, when you divide two integers, you are not getting an integer. When you divide two integers, you are. But it is not for all the cases. It should be for, if it is, in some cases you may get integers. But to get to check whether they are closed or not, we have to get in all the cases we should get. But here when you consider zero, you are not getting. That means integers are not closed under division. Therefore, integers are not closed under division. Okay, so this is about closure property. And then it's enough for you today. Tomorrow I'll explain about the commutative property, and then we'll have associative and distributive. Okay.